have less passengers.
3 months ago, I got on a train and I moved down to London. And here my room looks out across a river onto a building cloaked in scaffolding. And it's them, their composition, the way one leads into the next, supporting, upholding, embracing, the way they interlock, suspended in space, held by friction, defined by the building with which they serve, that has inspired this project, making a freestanding lampshade.
So there came a point in our evolution when we didn't guide life by distrusting our instincts and had to think about it and had to purposely arrange and discipline and push our lives around in accordance with foresight and words and systems of symbols, accountancy, calculation, and so on. And then we worry. Once you start thinking about things, you worry as to whether you've thought enough.
So far, I've just been cutting my steel tubing down to length using a Bosch GSA reciprocating saw. And this is a tool you're going to see me using a lot in this project. Within a couple of seconds, I can quickly change out the blade and cut through a massive variety of the toughest materials, from hardened steel and cast iron to brick and concrete. And so far, I've just been using the carbide heavy metal blade, which has had a really nice wide blade, ensuring I'm getting perfectly straight and square cuts. But you're also going to see me using the wooden metal blade, which is perfect for cutting through reclaimed wood or pallets. These blades are the best your tool can get, massively exceeding the bimetal blades I used previously. And if you want to learn more about them, I'm going to have a video in the description below. But now, let's use them to cut a notch in the end of my steel tubing. And then I'm going to reinforce this joint with a piece of wood. Now that this end's sorted, I can make the lampshade that's going to slot into it. Over you, when you went so loud, the clouds will spin to sound. Over and around, it shakes all of the proud. All of the proud. With the lampshade made, the metalworking for this project is now done. So I can move on to the wood. And the first step is cupping the ends of the steel tubing. And then I can apply the same concept to the bottom and base of the tubing. However, this time I'm also gonna cut and glue a series of blocks together that this piece is gonna slot into. And then to connect the poles together, I'm making a really simple block that's been inspired by the way scaffolding connectors work. So the original plan was for this block to sit on the vertical piece, and then I could simply twist this knob to secure it in place. However, due to the way I've oriented the grain, whenever you try and tighten it, the force just separates the metal components. So, remade the blocks with the grain going in the opposite direction, and this allows them to actually have something to cut into. And then for the tightening knob, instead of using wood, instead I've used an offcut of metal. And this allows the lampshade to be inserted and adjusted to any orientation or height. Meaning all I have to do now is finish the component and add the light itself. This may be the light time. This may be the last time. This may be the last. Oh, it may be the last time. I don't know. Maybe the last time we sang together.